We have some wind with us here as a cold front starts to push across the region. We're going to see cooler conditions as we get into Sunday. But we're going to be looking at a windy Friday night here, and then the winds back off a little bit overnight tonight. And then as we head into Saturday, the winds will pick up right again into the teens and 20s with the occasional gusts around 30 miles an hour. Currently, winds in Idaho Falls 14 out of the southwest, and we're into the teens right now for Pocatello as well. Over to First Alert Viper Radar, as expected, I talked about this yesterday, how western Wyoming was under the risk of seeing a few scattered showers. Today, we did see that, but the showers are not really all that developed. We're not really getting anything drenching right now, especially for Teton County or Lincoln County. We're just getting a few light sprinkles into the mountains and foothills, and they're pushing off further into the east. We're looking at still a little bit of this high pressure still overhead for another day before this low takes over. Now, we're not getting the full effect of this low. No, it's going into Canada, Washington, northern Idaho, and Montana. But this branch here, the lower branch, as that front comes through on Saturday, that's what's going to hit us into Sunday. But it's a very quick moving system. We're not counting on much moisture. Vipercast tonight at 10 o'clock clearing out, and then we're starting to see some cloud cover coming in for Saturday around dinner time. I'm going to stop at 6 o'clock here for tomorrow night. Not much rain and snow really getting in here for the valley, so this is just going to be more of a nuisance weather pattern with a lot of wind, cooler temperatures, and a few scattered showers. Now, of course, we're going to see some rain and snow into the mountains. Late Saturday night, we're going to be looking for this moisture to come through, and Salmon could see the showers as early as 6 o'clock tomorrow evening, but we'll start to see more of these showers overnight in through Sunday. The snow level is going to drop to about 7,000 feet. More scattered showers in the forecast with mostly cloudy conditions for your Sunday, but we clear out rather quickly getting into Monday and Tuesday of the week ahead here. But there's a second cold front that's going to come off of that low as we get into Wednesday of next week. We're hitting 37 in Chouse tonight, 36 in Arco, upper 30s in Idaho Falls, with the upper 20s for Jackson Hole, and the same for Island Park. Mid to upper 30s for Blackfoot, Pocatello, lower 40s for Burley, and that's going to be the same for Twin Falls. You're hitting the mid-30s tonight for Soda Springs, and the lower 30s just a smidge above freezing for the low in Afton. Highs tomorrow, couple degrees cooler. Not much different from today's high to tomorrow's high, but you're going to notice the wind. It's going to feel colder outside for your Saturday with a 67 in Pocatello and Blackfoot, mid-60s in Idaho Falls, and the mid-60s also for Rexburg, lower 60s as you get around Ashton and St. Anthony. And I'm going to go with the lower 60s in Mackey, upper 50s for Stanley, and a 65 as you get into Chow. So here's the two cold fronts coming through here. For tomorrow, the cold front comes through, and then we start to drop the temperatures back into the upper 50s for Sunday. This is the Idaho Falls 8-day forecast. Upper 50s, lower 60s for Monday. Notice, though, the numbers perk back up for Tuesday. That's ahead of the second cold front. So we're getting walloped twice here in the 8-day forecast, and we're getting the temperatures to drop back into the lower 60s for Wednesday, and then we clear up rather quickly here for Thursday, Friday, and leading into next weekend. But it's going to be cool and seasonal as we get into the following weekend at the end of the 8-day forecast. Let's go to Pocatello. Highs here pushing around 67 for Saturday, 59 on Sunday, and then the lower 60s for Monday with the lower 70s for Tuesday. That's ahead of the second cold front. And then we get hit again with cooler conditions and scattered showers for Wednesday. Rexburg also temperatures here dropping into the mid-50s for Sunday. Scattered showers in the forecast. And I'm not counting on a ton of rain here with the Sunday storm. No, most of the heavy rain and snow will be into the high country. Blackfoot also looking to bring in those scattered showers. Highs into the upper 50s for Sunday, lower 60s on Monday, and the lower 70s for Tuesday. Salmon could start to see the showers, like I said, tomorrow evening, but more of the showers into Sunday will clear out for a day, Tuesday, and then more often on showers all throughout next week. Salmon could see some spotty rain showers next weekend as well. This weekend in Jackson, it's going to be cold and windy with a high of 51 on Sunday. That could be a snowy start, but most of the snow that we're picking up in Jackson will be into the foothills and mountains around Jackson Hole and through the national parks. Our Spirit of Idaho, real quick here, we got this beautiful shot from Mike Adams of the windmills, and you can see the storm clouds off to the east. A very typical picture around here, especially when you get those storm clouds over the foothills and mountains with the uplift, and they build to the east of the Snake River Plain. So, beautiful.